The next process we want to tackle is meiosis. And meiosis is a very specialized kind of cellular reproduction that produces gametes and allows us to be ready for sexual reproduction. Our first definition is gametes, and these are the sex cells, sperm and egg in animals, and then pollen is going to be related to sperm in plants. When we say a cell is haploid, we're saying that that cell has half the normal amount of DNA. Half the normal amount means it has one copy of each gene, and we refer to a haploid cell as a 1N cell. Diploid, di means two, is a cell that has the normal amount of DNA. But remember, the normal amount is two copies of each gene, and so a cell with the normal amount of DNA would be a 2N cell. So sexual reproduction is when two organisms exchange gametes to create a third genetically unique individual. The zygote is the name of the new diploid cell that's formed by sexual reproduction. If we look at the human life cycle, we're going to take a haploid sperm and a haploid egg. These are both produced by meiosis, and together we're going to get a zygote, which is now 2N. And now that cell is going to grow into 2 cells, and then 4 cells, and then 8 cells through the process of mitosis. So we can look at the human life cycle and see where meiosis and mitosis fit in. If we want to start here with two adult individuals, they are going to go through meiosis only in the gonads, in the testes, and the ovaries. The woman is going to make eggs, the man is going to make sperm. All of their cells are 2N, that's the normal amount, but through this specialized process, they're going to make these 1N cells. The 1N cells are then going to meet in fertilization, and we're going to create this zygote. And the zygote is going to go through cell divisions, regular mitosis. We're going to make identical cells over and over and over again until you're ready to be born. And then growing into adult, that's all mitosis. So notice meiosis is a very small part of the life cycle. And meiosis is not the same as fertilization. Not all sperm, not all eggs are going to be involved in sexual reproduction. But meiosis is the process that creates these gametes so we have the potential for fertilization. Once fertilization occurs, then we're just using mitosis. We want the same number of cells, 2N, all the way through until we're producing sex cells again. So in meiosis, we're going to take one diploid cell, one regular, everyday 2N cell, and we're going to create 4 haploid cells from it. Each of those haploid cells is going to be genetically unique, and each is going to have half the normal amount of DNA. So meiosis is the process of making sex cells or gametes. It's going to occur only in the ovaries and testes. And in meiosis, we have 2 sets of cell divisions. We go through prophase, metaphase, anaphase 1, and then we do a whole second set of divisions, prophase, metaphase, anaphase, telophase 2, so that we end up with 4 cells.